लाइट्स, कैमरा, एक्शन, द लाइफ एंड टाइम्स ऑफ दादा साहेब फाल्के, ऑथर रूपाली भवे, इलस्ट्रेटर सुनैना नायक कांजीलाल, पब्लिशर प्रथम बुक्स, अ लेवल फॉर स्टोरी। नाउ लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द स्टोरी। कम वन, कम ऑल, सी अ परफॉर्मेंस विद 57,000 फोटोग्राफ्स, ऑल दिस फॉर जस्ट 3 आनास। Watch people move in the magic photographs. A picture 2 miles long. Only 3 anas. So this is a story of the olden times wherein there were no film movies. So this man is calling people to see magic photographs in which they can see moving pictures with the collection of photographs. A man was calling out to passers-by outside Bombay's Coronation Theatre. It was the 3rd of May 1913. Most people ignored him and continued walking by, thinking that he was crazy. Some gave him strange looks. However, a few curious folks gathered around the man. "Arre, what are you talking about?" an onlooker demanded. "Raja Harishchandra has been released today. It is a film," the man replied enthusiastically. "A film? What's that? Is it like a play?" the onlooker asked. "A little, but instead of live people, photographs will move. You will see Raja Harishchandra's story being performed. It has magic in it too. Do you want to watch it? The ticket is just 3 anas. The man said. After a brief discussion among themselves, the group of onlookers decided to give it a try. They were the first audience of India's first silent film, Raja Harishchandra, and its maker was none other than Dada Saheb Phalke. Dhundiraj Govind Phalke, more popularly known as Dada Saheb Phalke, was a photographer and a magician who had also studied painting and sculpting, dramatics and architecture at the Sir Jamsetji Jiji Bhoi School of Art and the Maharaja Sayaji Rao University of Baroda. He was always involved in some new creative pursuit or the other. One day, Dada Saheb Phalke went to watch the film, The Life of Christ. He was mesmerized by what he saw. He felt it was magical. He was a photographer. But even then, this was all new to him. He came home and shared his experience with his wife Saraswati. "Saraswati," he said, "I take still pictures. But these pictures were moving. There were people in those pictures. They moved like they did in real life. I was so fascinated that I watched the next show too." So he was very attractive towards these moving pictures. Saraswati smiled. She knew her husband's childlike enthusiasm very well. "You know, I am going to learn how to make these moving pictures. I will make films in India and tell Indian stories through films," he declared. Although Dada Saheb was very passionate about everything that he did, he was not very successful in his businesses. So some people called him crazy. But his wife Saraswati recognized his talent and passion. She was proud of him. Even in periods of financial hardship, she stood by him like a rock. Saraswati decided to support him in this plan too. Before making films, Dada Saheb Phalke had a photography studio at Godhra. But soon he had to close it down. Do you know why? It is because during those times, people believed that when the camera took your picture, it sucked out the soul of the person. So nobody was willing to get themselves photographed. So isn't it amazing? We didn't know all this thing about photography and beliefs of people in olden times regarding photography. I'm falling short of money to go to England, Saraswati. What can we do? Dada Sahib said, expressing his concern. Don't worry, sell off some of these things. We can do without them, said Saraswati. So with his wife supporting him, Dada Sahib Phalke used up all his savings and sold some household items and went to England in 1912. He learned the craft of filmmaking from Britain's pioneer filmmaker Cecil Hepworth. In order to understand all about filmmaking, Dada Sahib Phalke taxed his eyes with intense viewing and experimentation. As a result, his health suffered. He went blind. Much to his relief, he recovered his sight after a temporary blindness. Isn't it ironical? A man who was so driven to make films lost his sight, one of the most essential senses needed for a filmmaker. When he returned to India, he was raring to go. He wanted to make a film. With great excitement, he shared his plans with his family and friends. Some of his friends thought he had lost his mind. In fact, they even tried to get him admitted to an asylum. Once again, his wife was his only supporter. Despite his friends' reaction, Dada Sahib Phalke was determined to make a film. So he went about raising funds. Alas, nobody was willing to put their faith in him. It seemed that his dream would not be fulfilled. Not one to accept defeat. He pledged his life insurance policies and Saraswati sold her jewelry to raise money for the film. With that money, he ordered a camera and other equipment from Germany, but it wasn't sufficient to make a film. So he had a difficult journey in making a film, but he did it. And how he did it, let's see and listen to his difficult journey. So to help financiers understand the impact of films, he made a short film called Growth of a Pea Plant. He planted a pea and shot it at intervals over a period to demonstrate how the pea sprouted and grew tendrils. This short film had the desired impact on financiers and he got some loans. He began to plan his first film in all earnest, but he couldn't think of a suitable topic. The whole family would have animated discussions about which story to choose. Saraswati would suggest a story and he would reject it. For some reason, he would suggest one and the children would reject the idea. And so it went on till one day he found what he was looking for. He decided to make a film based on King Harishchandra. And this is how he decided to make this film. Indian audiences will love a mythological story since they are so religious. I could bring in the elements of mystery and magic. I know how to do it. The more I think of it, the more I like my idea, he exclaimed to Saraswati and the children. Dada Sahib had studied painting. He was greatly influenced by the prolific painter Raja Ravi Verma's work. He was himself a painter. He had studied at the JJ School of Arts. He used this knowledge and expertise while devising scenes in the film that made them even more effective. But where will you get the actors? And who will handle the camera? Asked Saraswati, very worried. You will handle the camera. I'll teach you and we'll advertise in the newspapers for actors. It's decided then, Dada Sahib declared. But it was easier said than done. Dada Sahib couldn't find many actors willing to act in a film. In those days, acting was considered a lowly profession. People were ashamed to become actors. So these are all the hurdles which he faced to make his first film. It was not an easy task in those times because of the beliefs of the people regarding acting. The real problem began when he started looking for women to play different female roles in the film. It was taboo for women to act. Not a single woman agreed to act in his film. He found a solution by casting men in female roles. But he was determined to have a woman play the lead role. He was stuck. Suddenly, he had an idea. He said to his wife, "Saraswati, I have decided that you will be the lead actress." But Saraswati firmly refused and said, "I am already involved in so many things. If I act too, who will do all the things I am doing now? I won't act in the film." Finally, he decided to cast a male actor, a cook, from a restaurant, in the lead female role. Saraswati Phalke, Dada Saheb Phalke's wife, is regarded as the first Indian film editor. Not only did she manage her family of 9 children, but she cooked food for the entire film unit, comprising 60 to 70 people, held white bed sheets for hours in the blazing sun as light reflectors, mixed film developing chemicals, perforated the raw film sheets at night in the light of a candle, and also edited the film. She had a great role. Dada Saheb Phalke's entire family was involved in the film. His son played the role of King Harish Chandra's son. Later, he cast his daughter Mandakini as Lord Krishna in Shri Krishna Janma and Kaliya Mardaan. Both films were big hits. So his family members turned out to be actors of different films. With the filming of Raja Harish Chandra, began a series of funny and memorable incidents. One day, an actor came to Dada Saheb and said, "Dada Saheb, I'm leaving. I can't act in a film." "But why?" demanded Phalke. "My parents don't want me to act. They said they don't mind if I sit at home and do nothing, but they will not allow me to act. If the news gets out that I am an actor, no girl will marry me," said the actor and left. Dada Saheb realized that soon other actors would come to him with the same problem. So he came up with an idea. He instructed his cast and crew to tell their families that they were working in Phalke's factory instead of film. Wow, that was the perfect solution by then. To train his male actors to play female roles effectively, Dada Saheb made them dress up as women even when they were not shooting. They had to do all the things that only women did at that time, such as cooking, washing and cleaning. The actors must have had so much fun doing that. There are many firsts to Dada Saheb's name. He made the first Indian silent film. His wife Saraswati was the first Indian film editor. He was the first to introduce a female actor in Indian films. His daughter Mandakini was India's first female child star. His eldest son Balchandra became the first Indian male child star in Raja Harish Chandra. So that sounds great and amazing. He was the first to do so many things. One day, the shooting was to take place in a jungle near a village. Since they wouldn't be able to dress up and put on makeup in the jungle, Dada Saheb decided that everybody would dress up and go to the shooting location in their film costumes and carry their property with them. As it was the story of a king, naturally, some actors were carrying swords. On the way to the jungle, while passing through the village, the villagers mistook them to be dacoits and sent policemen to arrest them. Finally, after a long journey of many ups and downs, Dada Saheb Phalke released India's first silent film, Raja Harish Chandra, in 1913. He was the producer, director and writer of the film. His efforts had borne fruit. At first, the film did not do well. But Phalke's Never Say Die spirit came to the rescue. He got two European dancers to perform before the film began and offered prizes to ticket buyers. Audiences flocked to the theater to watch the dance and walked out mesmerized by the film. So all the efforts were not wasted. Word spread, and day by day the size of the audience increased. The film became a hit. Not only did Phalke recover all costs and pay back his financiers, he also made a very good profit. Thanks to his perseverance and passion, by 1920, there was a flourishing film industry in Bombay, now known as Mumbai. So he was so passionate about following his passion that he turned it out into a success. Today, films are a medium of our creative expression. We enjoy movies that have Indian themes and actors. They are largely made by Indians. The film industry is a thriving business that provides employment to thousands. We owe it all to the foresight and brilliance of one man, Dada Saheb Phalke. The Dada Saheb Phalke Award is India's highest award in cinema. It was introduced by the Government of India in 1969 to commemorate Dada Saheb Phalke's contribution to Indian cinema. In 1971, in his honor, the Indian Post released a postage stamp bearing his face. The film city in Mumbai, where most films are shot, is named Dada Saheb Phalke Chitra Nagari after him. Dada Saheb Phalke is truly the father of Indian cinema. Thank you, children.